For the past 3 years, I've been making YouTube videos, and my retentions always looked like this. However, lately, my retentions have been looking like this. So, what changed? Well, I will let you in on a little secret. I published my first ever YouTube video back in 2012. The video is not public, so you won't be able to actually see it, but it's a video about how to create a simple beat in GarageBand.
Yo, what's up everyone? This is my first tutorial on how to use GarageBand.
I was just 16 years old and I made that video simply because I was making these beats, I was having fun, and I thought, hey, let me share with others what I have learned. After that video, I didn't publish anything until January 5th, 2020, when I decided to pursue YouTube seriously.
What's up you guys, it's George here, and in this video,
I remember I watched a video from Graham Stephan where he revealed how much money YouTube actually pays him. And that motivated me so much that I decided that this is exactly what I want to do. At that time, I was doing dropshipping and I was getting a little bit of traction with it, so I decided, hey, let me share with others what I have learned. Hopefully you can see an emerging pattern here, which will help us understand the retention secret, which I'm about to reveal. So I'm making these e-commerce videos. They're absolutely terrible, but I'm refining my craft, and eventually some videos rank and they start to get consistent search traffic. However, every time I look at the retention graph, it always looked like this. Now, I did not understand why is there such a huge drop in the first 15 seconds of the video. I was reaffirming what that video is about. So if my video was about how to dropship on Amazon, then in the first 15 seconds, I said, I'm going to show you how to dropship on Amazon. By the way, I'm really sorry for that cringy intro. Ugh. So I was reaffirming the title, but still, the first 15 seconds, I saw a huge hockey stick drop. Now, here is where things got interesting. So I recently made a video titled Struggling to Choose a YouTube Automation Niche. This might help. And the retention on that video is 64%. And over 77% of people are still watching at the 30-second mark. So what's the difference between these two videos? Well, take a look for yourself. I recently started my first ever YouTube automation channel in the Make Money Online niche, and I absolutely hated it. So I decided to switch the niche, and here is how I'm going to do it. And now compare that to,
I'm going to show you how to dropship on Amazon.
Do you see and feel the difference? Yes, there is some difference in the quality of the video, audio, and the delivery, but by far, the biggest difference is what I say. Instead of me reaffirming what that person said, I introduce a story. Over sudden, there is a character, me. He's pursuing some kind of a goal, starting a YouTube automation channel. Something challenging happened to him. I chose a niche that I hated, and now he is changing it. How is he going to do it? The viewer is intrigued. He wants to know, how does this story evolve? How does it end? Because when you start your video saying, today I'm going to show you how to la 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 la, the person is like, yeah, I know what this video is about. I saw the title. He just skips ahead. Just show me the meat of the video. But when you say, I recently started a YouTube automation channel, and oh boy, it's not all rainbows and unicorns. Let me tell you why. The person is like, what does he mean by that? You create intrigue. Now the viewer wants to know what happened. Why is it not all rainbows and unicorns? What did he do to lose $2,000 starting YouTube automation? So here's some advice on how to improve your retention from me to you. Number one, tell stories. Don't make how-to tutorials. Share your goals, share your challenges, share how you were able to overcome them and what you have learned from it. Pro tip, study storytelling. Number two, write your script, but make sure to write it yourself so it reflects the way you actually talk in real life. It's not an essay you're submitting here. Be clear, but be yourself. Number three, find your style. Experiment with different backdrops, colors, music, editing styles. I quite like the way my videos sound and look and feel right now, but if you compare them to my first videos on YouTube, they were nowhere close as good as they are right now. Embrace what you like. I like dark tones, so my videos reflect that. I like classical music, so I use them in my YouTube videos. I talk in short sentences, so that's exactly how I write my scripts. You don't need to follow a cookie cutter advice because at the end of the day, you are creating art. All of this sounds easier than it actually is, but it's worth it because it brings out authenticity and your audience develops a much deeper connection with you because now they understand what kind of a person you really are. And lastly, try to make videos that you actually enjoy watching yourself. And by the way, don't take it from me. Listen to what MKBHD has to say about this.
The overarching goal behind everything, just to keep in the back of my head for all this stuff, is we want to make what we'd want to watch. And that actually, it translates pretty well towards like the entire business. And if you keep that in the back of your head towards any part of what we do, it makes a lot of sense. So when we consider like what videos we're gonna make, it's what would we wanna watch? What would we, it's like a tongue twister. What would we want to subscribe to? That's the type of channel we're trying to build.